Hello, YouTube. Good afternoon. I am Lachey. Hope you guys all enjoying your Thursday. I popped up with another topic. It's about relationship, and thought that would be good to talk about because today is my 15 years anniversary. Woohoo! Very, very happy to be in this relationship and married and enjoying this. A lot of people that are married are not always happy, not always satisfied with the person they marry. Their connection is not the same, having something in common, doing things that each other like. So it's a lot to understand in a marriage or getting involved with someone and being in that relationship forever. You know, you need to make sure that all those things a part of your relationship, because it can go sour just because you did not connect with something similar, liking the same food or liking the same movies or liking the same outing, the same events. You know, that's very important in a relationship. But before I even begin, you know, I always say my prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, as we forgive us our debt, as we forgive us our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, the glory is forever. Lord, O Lord, pray for everyone to have and to receive a blessing through my video. In Jesus' name, we ask and all. God bless. Woohoo! Got a chair hanging right there. Bang it! But anyway, we're just letting everyone know that I'm very happy about my relationship. And like I already did say, a lot of marriages are not happy. So what I like to discuss over the relationship, being married, if you've been married and you've been in that marriage past 5 years and up, you give yourself applause if your marriage, saying you guys two are happy in your relationship. That's very, very important. To make sure that the two of you are happy to be together and you want to be around each other and you don't mind being each other's company when others can't be around you. You know? So that's important if that is going on in your relationship. But if you're not offering the satisfaction with your marriage and you guys don't want to be around each other, that's a negative in the marriage. I understand we all need our separation, our time alone. Yes, everyone there. And some prefer hourly separation time. Some just want maybe 30 minutes separation time. Just remember, you choose who you're with. And when you become married to these people, you need to make sure that you have the several things that's in your marriage. Having something in common that you both like to do. You know, there's so many things that you can do in the marriage. Enjoying your outings, enjoying the same food, enjoying the same activities. You know, all those things are important. But when you do not do that, that hurts the relationship. That hurts the relationship. I'm not even speaking on man and woman. I'm speaking of either man and woman or same sex. Romance can be a lot of ways. Some do not care for romance, okay? It doesn't necessarily mean flowers and wine. Or bubble bath and candlelight, mean all that. It could mean holding hands, going for a walk, talking with each other about your day. That's already romantic. Spending some quality time with each other. Now, some people make this do with their children in law. What happened to the two of you? Your kids go to bed at night. What do you two do? Go to bed too, or you spend some time with each other? If you just take 1 hour of your day, every day, with each other, you two are going to feel good about each other. But like I already said, some people get married for the wrong reason. And I hope that you didn't do that. Get married for the children. Or got married because she's so beautiful. Or she's a good cook. Or she's a good housekeeper. Now there's a lot of reasons why some people get married to a person. I married my partner for our hearts. She gives me a lot of comfort, a lot of love, a lot of happiness. We can laugh at almost anything. We can talk about anything. And we have never allowed money to be a problem in our relationship. Now that's a lot of times that's what the problem is. Oh, I don't know how I can love you. You always get us broke all the time. And we ain't never got no money. And I don't even know how we're gonna get across the borderline now because you keep spending all the money, you know. Be real. Be real. Money may be an issue, but you have to figure out a way to solve. I'm happy with my relationship because when me and her met, we did not have money to cry about. We had each other, so that made our relationship strong. Happy, faithful, and encouraging one another. And that's nice when you have that in your relationship because it's hard when you don't have that. Very hard. Hard to do that. And also, a lot of people get with someone who's not, I call that, equal to them. Oh, maybe one person likes to go to church, the other one don't. This person may like sports and this one don't. This person likes to hang out with their friends and stuff. This person don't. As I already said, you should have something in common. And it should not be a little bit. It should be a lot. You should have a lot of things in common. Because the more you have in common, the more you will enjoy each other all the time. And that's important key. Have something in common. My partner and my wife, me and her, we like the same color. We like the same outdoors. We like the same food, most of it. I mean, we have a few things that we might dislike or something, but not as much as some people have. So I've heard and seen people say, well, I don't like that, so they cook something different. And this person eats this, and I said, why even be involved in that relationship if you have nothing in common? Have something in common. It's very important. I realize that now. I notice the more you have in common, the better. Oh, my partner and I love to cook. My partner loves to eat. My partner and I love going outside and working in the yard. We love it. We love neatness. We love having a good time. So the more, like I already just said, the more you have in common, you will feel better about your relationship. Marriage should not be on one specific reason why you married the person. It should be a lot of reasons why you married the person. On good terms. Not negative terms or bad terms. You know? And then also, when you get involved with someone, before even considering marriage, you should really make sure you know the person. Know all their L's, their history, their culture, their type of food they like, their clothes, their activities. You know, learn them. Take the time to learn them. Because the more we know who they are, the better you're going to feel. Should I go ahead and get married to that person or not? You know, and I'm not going to say how long you should wait for marriage because I got with my partner in 1 year. But everyone is different. It all depends on how much did you learn about that person. And I recommend more than a year. Because you're getting more deeper in knowing them, learning them. You know. That's why when they are together for 1 year, and say a year later to get engaged, you're getting that extra 1 more year. Some people depend on, ooh, his bad credit, oh my God, as long as I want to be with him. It's gonna make my name bad, da da da. I understand how you guys feel on that, but that's a poor reason to not be with someone. I just believe that if your heart's in the right place and everything connects, you should be fine and be able to help them as you help each other in that area. And if you are those types that are not in a relationship and want a relationship, make a list of what you want in that person, man or woman. Because it don't work out if you don't have any idea what you want in a mate. Some people prefer not to marry, that's fine. they want to be in a long-term relationship. There are a lot out there that are like that. That's fine too, just remember. Anything happens to them, you don't collect nothing. So that's how I see it. Being in a relationship requires everything. Knowing all about that person and accepting all of them. I mean, I would not want anyone to be with me and only love me for one thing, huh? Don't waste your energy and time. Oh, and that's another thing that should not be the main thing in your relationship is sex. Sex, okay, that's gonna get boring after a while. And that doesn't matter if you the same sex or a man or a woman. Sex becomes boring sometimes. And believe me, after so many years of being with that person, sex will die. And you have to figure out, what can I do to make it better? Exactly. And that's what guys have to remember. To make your relationship exciting, you gotta ask yourself, what can I do? There's a lot of things you can do to make your relationship exciting, depending on what the other person needs or wants. And be careful, because sometimes people get in a relationship for fantasy. Those things will die fast. So that's not important to be with people like that. Oh, I kind of like her. She got beauty. She's good in bed. That's not what a relationship should be. It should be on loyalty, love, happiness, trust, comfort, trying to get comfortable with each other, you know. Got a lot of things in common. Those are the kind of relationship should be a part of your relationship as marriage people. Or boyfriend or girlfriend, doesn't matter which way it is, it's really the key. You gotta really have loyalty in your relationship, no matter what. And that's important. And I know some people don't like to hear that, but it's the truth. You need to make sure everything on your list is almost a match. I feel like I got my twin. I'm serious. We have so much in common and anything. We can read each other like a book. And when you have that type of relationship, that is a true relationship. That means love is really, really in your relationship. And you also, people say, oh, well, we argue a lot. Do you argue once in a while? And how do you solve your argument? Do you guys go your separate ways and wait in the morning to cool off and sit and discuss it with each other? The more that you do that, the better. I don't recommend people arguing, but I know that you're going to have some disagreements sometimes, so that's normal. But when you do not have any problems in your relationship, that is, to me, that's not the way it goes. See, my partner and I don't argue like that, but we do have sometimes have disagreements. So we have to sit down and discuss. See how we're going to solve the problem. We go over the discussion and we try to make the best of agreement. once we feel like we got to make it work out. And that's important. I mean, the more that you try to solve your problems in your marriage or your relationship, that's important. And that means you care about a healthy relationship. But when I see people arguing, that means what? They're not solving the first argument. And then it increases, and increases, and increases, and increases, and increases, and it just makes it worse, and makes it tough for them to solve the problem. Solve the first argument before you go to the next. Don't start building that argument. Solve the one you start. And if you still can't solve the problem, then that's the question you have to ask yourself. If they refuse to solve the problem, the question you should be asking yourself and them, should we be even together if we can't even solve simple problems? Sometimes people arguing over some of those dumbest things. And even worse if they're arguing over the kids, or they're arguing over money, or they're arguing over different situations. I mean, you gotta take that seriously. How are you solving the problem? I cannot stand with, oh, I never have any problems in my relationship. And I ask myself, you know, like, everyone has their ups and downs. We do. So, how do you not have any problems in your relationship? You may not argue. You may just have disagreement once in a while. Well, that's normal. That is normal in a relationship. There is no such thing as a perfect relationship. Period. A beautiful relationship means you guys are solving your problem. When you two don't always agree to it, you discuss it, and you try to figure out the best solution to the problem. And the better you guys do that, you improve the relationship. The more that you develop improving your relationship, the better it is. And I mean, I know someone who's been married for 54 years. And very, very happy. And I never really hear them talk about their relationship, really. But I'm sure they have the ups and downs. There's no one has a perfect relationship. But you can also tell when someone is happy. And that's important to me. See, I have the one thing that bothers me the most with relationships. Is your spirit good with that person? Say you're a spiritual person and the other one's not. Then I don't know why you're with that person. They have nothing in common with you when it comes to that point. It's a little different if you got with that person and you both were not spiritual at the time and you finally accepted God in your life and you believe in a new path. Okay, that's a different story. That's kind of a harder solution to the problem. But you also have to remember, you can't expect them to change if just because you have changed. And that has to be on their doing. You've encouraged them, guide them, you know, to hopefully that they will set God in their life to wanting to walk that spiritual life. I mean, sometimes that happens in a relationship, you know. Your differences are not the same. That will happen. It don't happen often, but some people tend to have that problem. I think of my family, I have someone in my family that they both accepted God after they got divorced. I guess they didn't realize how bad their marriage was until they got divorced. And they realized the concept was either one of them were ready to be married, and either one of them were ready to be the parent or a husband or a wife. That's pretty sad when we have all these different categories in the marriage that already went dead in the marriage. You know? I tell you, and I specifically say marriage is a very, very hard category. If you're serious about being married and you're not in one yet, think about all the things that are required in a marriage. It's not a one person's job to do all the work in the marriage. It takes both of you to do the work in the marriage. That means both of you need to do the action in the marriage to see the marriage working out. It ain't gonna work out without the two of you not working with each other. It's required both of you to do the job. And I learned that too. And also, maybe one of you work full time and the other one works part time. Don't get frustrated. It's gonna be easier for that one person that's part time to do most of the work in the home. But let your mate understand that you also gonna need the help in some area. It's okay. It's alright. It's a 50-50. I recommend 100 on both ends. But if you're giving each other 50-50, that's better than nothing at all. Some people won't even do that. It's 50 on the lady and the man might be doing 20%. Or maybe it's 50% on the man and the woman's doing 20%. I've seen that before too. I've seen both sides doing that. That's why in a marriage, you need to make sure that the two of you are on the same page in everything. From the cleaning, to the cooking, to the kids, to the, you know, the bills paying, you know, all of that. But that's very, very important that you both are sharing the load, because it can be heavy if one's only giving 20%, the other one's doing 50%, that's not enough in a relationship, period. So that 20%, if you are giving 20% and you complaining and whining, oh, you don't spend no time with me, maybe you cut the load off of that person can spend some time with you. Think about that, you gotta remember that. So it's very important key that you both of you are giving each other the same amount of load to make it easy for each other. But believe me, when it's not even, it's not easy. And I understand sometimes one of you may be a full housewife. Okay, that's a bigger and different situation. You're going to be the one that comes to first. You're going to be the one that's going to clean. You're going to be the one folding the clothes. You're going to be the one doing the laundry. You're going to be the one going to the grocery store, going shopping. So that might change things a little bit. But remember, that is still 50%. The person that goes to work also got to remember that whatever you do, they can do something different, like yard work should be for them. Washing the car should be for them. There's a lot of things you can be equal about when it comes to a housewife. My mother was one for a long time. She couldn't stand it. I never understood why. Now I know why. You could not get equal in the marriage. so I can, I understand now. My part and I are a little bit different than that. Yes, I do the housework. Yes, she, on the weekends she would do the cooking, she would do the car cleaning, do the yard work. So already that's a lot of work. So I feel like that's equal in my eyes. But then again, everyone has it different. They might see and have a different opinion on that, that's all. So. Anyway, I just wanted to share my experience in the marriage and what I have learned from other people's marriages. How to make yours as beautiful as it can be. Give yourself applause if you have passed 5 years and you're happy in your marriage or your relationship. Remember that that's a plus in that. I am still offering prayer circles. Contact me if you're interested. My prices are anywhere from $20 to $60. I will put down my email to contact me, and please follow the email that I put down on the video clip. So I hope you guys all have a wonderful, blessing Thursday. Bye!